Fake news. The political battle gets ugly, and the bubble continues to grow. What's up, everybody? Welcome aboard to Bubba's Bottom Line. It is Sunday, July the 19th, and what's going on, everybody? Another crazy week in the world of politics, sports, markets, nothing. We're getting wilder and wilder as we go, but in the meantime, one of the big things we're seeing here is the deep state trying to get dirty and down and dirty, okay, as they continue to try to change everything so that they can assume control. And they probably cannot be happier between the BLM movement and the new anti-Semitic comments that are being made, getting everybody to battle against each other while they're in there sneaking around and manipulating and maneuvering themselves to retake the country from the one man that is not on the payroll of all the lobbyists and all the countries around the globe. But we continue to see that the battles are heating up, okay? And it's getting dirtier and dirtier, and there are more things coming out, but it's amazing how we never see anything dirty about the deep state and the things that they've done to get to where they are. We've never heard about many of these secret little endeavors that have been built and have destroyed in America from the inside. But of course, we will continue to see that the left, getting farther left, will continue to tell their lies and tell their things and continue to be trying to promise many that it will be better when they're getting everything for free. And the right's no better. Okay, again, I don't support either side with the more free money and everything else that they want to do and trying to figure out ways, because this is something that I think should concern everybody, no matter which side of the aisle you sit on, for your future. Okay, do we want to continue to watch politicians, career politicians, try to buy elections with BS that they will never deliver on? Okay. Again, right now, and the left wants to keep the poor, but give them just enough so that they can continue to be vote for them. And the right wants to do something more for big business. I get it all. There's not a thing here, but we do need big business to put people back to work. We do need to continue to get off this free money train and make people go back to work. I mean, it's a pretty logical question. If you're making $30,000 or $50,000 a year, okay, at your job, or you can make $30,000 to $50,000 a year sitting home, what are you going to do? Well, I mean, I know I'm going to go to work, and I know many of you will, but the majority will sit home and take the money for nothing. But who is really paying for that? And the answer is the taxpayer, and we are. And with tax day just passing, I'm getting sick and tired of it, okay? Again, and I look, neither party here is innocent. There are so many career jackasses on both sides of the aisle, okay, that we need to take away and start to limit some of the we have to have term limits on everyone. And I think it should start with the president to be 1 6-year term. Okay, and I think the House and the Senate should be a maximum of 2 terms. Okay, they can make them a little bit longer. They can make them, 2 4s, or instead of the every 2, whatever. But again, this is getting to be a joke, and we're seeing more of our money pissed away on a ridiculous election. Okay, and where I believe, in my honest opinion, that the left knows they're not going to win this election. And they're throwing up this guy who is going into dementia. Okay, again, this is not my opinion. This is some medical fact that some of these signs, the early signs that Joe Biden shows. Okay, besides the man's been in office for 51 years and has done nothing in 51 years. But again, I believe, my personal opinion is, he is a sacrificial lamb, very much as McCain and Palin were in 08 against Obama, because the right knew they weren't going to beat Obama in 08, so they threw up nobodies. And I believe that you're seeing the left do similar, preparing for the election of 2024, not 2020. But in the meantime, while they're waiting, they will create as much havoc as they can. And again, I am not taking a particular side in this argument, because I wasn't happy that the right held up Merrick Garland from Supreme Court a couple of years ago, right before the election. In the meantime, the battle is dirty, and the politicians are dirty, and the media is dirty. And again, you listen to one channel, and you think of one thing. I mean, so it's because, and this Jim Acosta is a dope. Okay, again, it's amazing how we can take words and turn them into little phrases. Okay, and make a big mess. And of course, that's been the case for years. But we're getting not only is the political parties getting farther and farther apart, the media is getting farther and farther apart, and it's a battle to see who can stick it worse. In the meantime, okay, look, I don't know why we have not seen the legalization of marijuana federally. Okay, I don't know. Understand? We need the money. We need the taxes. It's already legal in many, many states. Why not make it federal and tax it like they do everything else? Okay, why not make sure, just like with gambling now? Why are they? Why is government in general making it so challenging to do something that makes so much sense that it's ridiculous? Okay, gambling and marijuana are a couple of the biggest industries out there that are more handled underground than they are on top. Why not bring them on top and get the tax money? Okay, let the product pay the taxes. But of course, one problem we know about is, for example, in the state of Illinois, the wonderful piece of crap of Illinois, okay, they want to tax the gambling revenue so heavily that they want to take more than the bookmaker, the legalized bookmaker, can make. Because if you don't understand gambling, okay, bookmakers are working on a 5% edge, okay? Again, it's not, the players aren't at a dramatic disadvantage, but the bookmaker is doing is they want to get money on both sides and collect their 5% juice. That's what they're trying to do, okay? But when you want to tax them at 20%, it's hard when you're working on a 5% margin. In the meantime, okay, again, but why isn't it that we don't have these companies so that we can actually see some major funds start to invest in these, and we cannot see some real growth, okay? And we can even get some retail growth, which might bring people back to some of the brick and mortar stores. I mean, again, it's so simple, it's ridiculous, okay? But of course, this is the part of a political battleship, okay, that for whatever reason, we have to continue to go through the same with the COVID, which we will talk about in our commentary. But again, you have those that are on the left talking about how many people are unemployed, and those on the right are talking about how many people they just employed. But so, you know, again, we just had another jobless claims of 1.3 million. Look, we know if the country is going to be shut down again, that there's going to be more unemployment again. Okay, so where is the surprise? Why does it come in the minds of those that it's a big deal? If you close, okay, then you have no jobs. Pretty simple, okay? But of course, they've destroyed small business, which is even worse. Okay, think about it. Okay, your local neighborhood, your little grocery store, your little pantry, your little shoe store maybe you go to, whoever you may, your restaurants for sure, okay, why is it that we want to destroy all of our small business entrepreneurs that work so hard to get there, okay? Think about the reasoning behind that. The next time you decide on who you want to support, think about the reasoning of why you want to put out of business all of these small guys, okay? These small individuals that have worked their ass off, they get to a point, and maybe they owe a lot of money, maybe they don't, but they built a business that is feeding them and their family and a few employees, and yet you want to put them out of business, okay? It makes no sense to me whatsoever, okay? And of course, we had last week, they had an inflation report. Oh, surprise, we do have some inflation. But of course, the way the cockeyed government counts, and this has been forever, okay, they don't want to count food and energy in inflation statistics. They want to count the refrigerators that you buy every 12 years or 15 years or whatever it is, okay, that they've come down in price, or computers that you don't buy every day. But the things you use every day are very inflationary, okay? And again, have you bought a steak lately at the grocery store throughout all this or whatever? So, you know, have you gone to dinner at a restaurant in New York, okay, for, you know, a $175 steak? I mean, look, at the end of the day, we've got inflation, and the stupid Federal Reserve should quit fiddling around with monetary policy. Okay? I can't believe they're allowing the banks to do what they're doing, and no limit on lending to the what's supposed to be in a reserve. Okay? You don't think that will lead into a problem? Okay, is this going to be, are we thinking that this time is different as we watch the Robin Hood traders go crazy building this bubble that continues to expand? You know, I've been through this. I'm going on my third one, okay, in my career, starting in the 80s, okay? You know, again, everybody thought that in the 80s the market would never go down again either. And then, of course, into the 90s, into the early 2000s. And of course, in 08. Now, we got it again. Now, again, I'm not saying the market's going down tomorrow. You know that. Okay? I'm just saying that you have to understand some of the valuations, okay? Value investing is dead, according to many. Now, of course, we know that that's not true. We know that this will, again, end up in heartbreak and misery for many, okay? You know, the forcing people into equities when they would rather be like in bonds or in the bank, okay? But you've taken away that opportunity for many, which is a bigger problem. Again, you have a huge demand for borrowing of money, okay? You've lifted the restrictions on the banks, okay? They are slowly ticking up their interest rates, okay? But again, every time the bank makes a loan, they are actually also printing new money, which makes the value of your dollars less. So again, this goes back to my whole argument against the Federal Reserve to begin with, is that they allow things to happen. They are a party to a lot of them, even though they're a private corporation, okay? They were named the Federal Reserve to have the imagination that they were part of the government, okay? Which they're not, okay? They're owned by J.P. Morgan, by the Rothschild family, and by others, Morgan Stanley. So again, it's a crock of crap that we continue to have to deal with as they continue to put their hands in your pocket and in my pocket, taking our hard-earned money for the crappy programs that they want to create for everybody. So if you like that, then you should continue to support them. But unfortunately, most of us were educated under that type of plan and refused to want to believe to get off that kind of plan, okay? Which is totally absurd. But again, I can't fault you for your training, for what you learned in school. But of course, we know the schools, from the very little middle schools, nursery schools, all the way to the universities, what do they teach? They teach liberal politics. They teach free money. That's what they teach you. Okay, so it only makes sense that in this country, we have no financial literacy. Okay, that nobody really even understands how a market works. Okay, and that is sad from my state of view. Okay, that is very sad as you start to see some of these issues once again that are going to destroy another generation with a lot of the stupid policies we're watching. This is Bubba's Bottom Line. Todd Bubba Horwitz. It's always great to be with you. We're going to step out of here for a break, and we'll be right back with more after the break. Well, kids, you know, as you know, I talk all the time about, you know, the brokerage partners that I have. Now, you know, again, I always want to make it clear, I have more than one brokerage account with different vendors, okay? But when it comes to where I want to be active or I want to do things, I have, for futures and commodities, I use CTG Group, okay? They do a phenomenal job with my stuff. Now, I let them use letter of direction trading. They do all of my letter of direction trading, all of our clients' letter of direction trading. I let them do it. Why? Because they do it timely. They get great pricing. They take care of you. And when you get a question, you pick up the phone. Somebody answers the phone. Nothing is better for me than when somebody answers the phone. Okay. So CTG for futures and commodities, and for equities and options, okay, it's Tradier. Okay. Again, Tradier is phenomenal in the industry. They continue to work with new technology. They continue to be zero commissions. It's a $10 a month fee, okay, that you pay to be part of Tradier. So again, even though you're paying 65 cents or you think you're free, Tradier is really free, $10 a month. And they get great customer service. And by the way, I'm doing a webinar with Tradier on Wednesday at 2 o'clock Eastern time. So if you want to check that out, go to tradier.com. You'll check it out. You'll see the webinar that I'm going to do, and I'm very excited to do it for them. And of course, if you want information on either CTG or Tradier, email me at bubba@bubbatrading.com, and I'll send you their special links. And of course, Family Farms, okay, another great organization that we have partnered with. Okay, they're with it's a farming organization that helps farmers and teaches and does things. And of course, we're doing a webinar for them on Tuesday. If you want more details, email me. But again, I'm telling you that it's a great group that I fell in love with the minute I met them when I spoke for them over a year ago. And I encourage you to check out Family Farms as well. They're a great partner. And of course, don't forget about our commodity report. Okay, look, if you're a commodities trader, if you're a trader of any sort, Andy Hecht, is number one of the best writers around. You can check him out on Seeking Alpha. He's the number one writer on Seeking Alpha. Number two, he's a former banker from a trading standpoint, was the biggest silver trader in the world at one time, and also lived all over the world, okay, trading physical commodities. He does a report that will also help you, even if you don't trade commodities, he gives you the appropriate ETFs and gives you a weekly spreadsheet, okay, plus the quarterly reports that just came out. It's called Technamental. Go to bubbatrading.com and check it out, okay, Technamental at bubbatrading.com. And of course, our high school program, as we get ready, I'm getting ready to reshoot all the lessons again, as we have some things that'll change. Obviously, some things have changed in the economy. But if you want to help us out, go to Patreon, patreon.com/BubbaTrading. That's patreon.com/BubbaTrading. In the meantime, let's get back to Bubba's Bottom Line with me, Todd Bubba Horwitz. Welcome back, everybody. This is Bubba's Bottom Line. It is Sunday, July the 19th, and you know, markets, it's almost funny, right? It's almost comical to watch these markets go up day after day after day, okay? And as you know, this week, we were always long the NASDAQ. We have not, we've been long the NASDAQ this time since April 3rd, I believe, either 3rd or 10th, doesn't matter. One of those two, we've been long the NASDAQ, have never wavered, okay? We were long the other indexes, got short them after the 1,800-point down day, and then we got long again this week, last week, okay? But at the end of the day, I don't really care one way or the other. I mean, again, I'm not going to have an opinion and predict the market. I know that this is a bubble, and I know that it's going to pop, and I know it's going to be ugly. But you know what? Our algorithms will sniff that out long before it actually collapses. Okay, so we'll be prepared, and we'll be short, and we'll be ready. So I'm not at all concerned about it. So right now, We are still long. We are long the Dow. We are long the S&P. We are long the NASDAQ and still short the Russell. Okay. And again, that's not changing at least until Tuesday. But I don't foresee it changing anytime soon as long as the Robinhood traders. And again, think of some of the things that are happening right now. Buying slices of stock. So now, you know, it reminds me of Forex when you could name your pip size. Okay. You go to a penny a pip or whatever you want. This is a way just to track in more new money that will continue to get ready when it goes to explode, because you think these people that are buying fractional shares of things are going to have the heart to gut through a gut-wrenching collapse. No, they're not. So again, we'll see what happens. In the meantime, the metals, they continue to try to go. Now, again, it was interesting early in the week. Gold and silver were flying. Now, silver had a great week. Gold had an okay week. But at the end of the day, gold defended the $1,800 level, which was huge in our opinion. Okay. And again, I believe this is a rally. You know, I don't know if it's going to be tomorrow. I mean, it won't be tomorrow, but I don't know if it's going to be soon or, you know, a couple months from now. But I think this rally, the current bull market is in, that we're long. We've been long since like 1500, okay, or 1590, I think it was. And it doesn't matter what the price is. I think we're going to be long all the way through all-time new highs. I don't think we're going to see a reversal until then. Okay. So again, and I'm just saying that I think silver has got a good chance to get to the mid-20s now. So everything looks great, and platinum looks like crap, which is perfect because we're short platinum. Long gold, long silver, short platinum. Oil, as you know, I tell you every day, I hate it. I'm long it. I hate it. I'm still long though. Now again, the good news for me is it's been resisting at 41 around that neighborhood. But also it is our sell point, because of the way the algorithm is designed, continues to rise. Okay, so it will take less of a sell-off for me to get to reverse to be where I want to be. But again, I do not trade with my opinion, especially when I'm carrying many positions. And because I've got 7 futures portfolio accounts myself, okay, I'm not going to get opinionated there. I'm going to let the markets tell me what to do because I follow the rules. Okay, bonds and notes were still long. Again, I hate those two. But again, I don't get in the way. You know, I mean, before I was using the algorithm 20 years ago, we used to fight the bonds and, you know, fight the Fed and the Fed wins. Fight the bonds and, you know, again, you can't fight a market. You can't wish it to go in your direction, whichever way it happens to be. So we're still long bonds and notes. Copper, you know, I don't know. Is copper sending us a message? Okay. You know, it was having a huge week last week and suddenly had a reversal, I think Wednesday. Okay. From up big to down, and of course we call that a key reversal. It looks like a bad weekly candle. I'm not a candle trader, but it looks like a bad weekly candle too. We'll see. I mean, we're still long copper. It has not changed yet, but certainly it could be changing. The winds could be changing, but copper could be that could be the first sign that the excitement for all this economy might be failing. The dollar, well, we did finally reverse the dollar, or we will be tonight or tomorrow morning. Again. The dollar is under a lot of pressure. You know, it's under siege because of the Federal Reserve, because of the manipulation, not only the Fed, but the central banks around the world. The Ponzi scheme depends on the ability to devalue currency. And again, they're all fighting down to zero, which is going to lead us to that digital currency world, which, trust me, you're going to hate it. Okay. Trust me, you're going to hate being tracked every moment of every day, wherever you spend anything. Okay, it's bad enough that they can kind of watch you with credit cards. Imagine when they can start watching you with cash too. Okay, so I warn you about what's going on in the euro currency. We're still long. Okay, so we had the spread. So now we're going to be short. Now we're going to be extra long the euro currency or extra short the dollar, because the euro currency is the biggest component of the dollar index. But it'll be what it'll be. And natural gas is, you know, it's kind of murky. We're long it. It was down last week. But it doesn't move much. To me, see here, at these levels of natural gas, it's hard for me to want to be shorted. So I don't really want the signal to change. And not because I don't mind being short, but I know that as we continue to troll into weather events that can start to happen soon, okay, you get these major spikes because with natural gas guys, they burn off the excess. And then when they need it, they're none there. Anyways, so we'll see. Again, we're still long it for now, which I prefer to be on the long side. Or out, but again, obviously we're never out, so I'll either be long or short. But no, I'm still long, and will continue to be so. And when we take a look now into the grain markets, okay, now we're short corn, we're short beans, unfortunately. Okay, we had caught in the downdraft, and we're short yet short. Okay, which is fine. Look, it's fine, but you know my true views are I'd love to be long grains here. Okay, I mean, but again, I'm not going to fight it, but I wouldn't be afraid again. If you have equity and money and you're not a trader and you're just looking for something to buy and hold, I'd be a buyer and holder of corn. Okay. That would be me personally. But again, I'm still short right now. So full disclosure, I'm short. Okay. I'm short beans right now. I'm long wheat. And that's our positions, obviously. Short corn, short beans, long wheat. And wheat looks like it had a monster, two monster weeks in a row. But the first, the 2 weeks ago was because of one day. But it doesn't matter why. When you look at a weekly chart, that's what you see. Okay, so again, and now hogs start to be picking up a little bit. We're still short, but I know it's like inches from changing. Okay, but we got those limit updates. We got them almost back to back, right? I knew it was coming. And this is one thing about understanding markets in general. I knew it was coming at some point. Okay, and it came. Okay. So, hey, good. In the meantime, we're still long cattle, and they're both breaking out. And I look for a lot longer run. I see very good things happening in the ag space for the long run here. And I think the worst is now over for farmers, which I'm thrilled because they're such wonderful people in general, working their ass off for no money. And now I think finally, after the last few years of crap, they're going to get something good. So I'm pretty excited. You know, again, not tomorrow, but down the road a little bit here, I think it's all good. You got J.P. Morgan, Jamie Dimon calling for the end, okay? Billionaires selling their stocks. What does it all mean? It doesn't mean anything. Watch the price action. Any news item that you think you're going to trade off, that bank, that person, that big billionaire, they've already made their trade. They're just letting you know so you can help them. Don't you remember when a certain Carl icon used to tweet out about a stock he would buy after he bought it? And then it would put it up even higher. So again, please don't try to trade the news or you lose. This is Bubba's Bottom Line. Todd, Bubba Horwitz, we're going to step out here for a break and we're going to come back with my commentary after the break. Bubba's Bottom Line. So kids, you know, hey, Tuesday, I'll be doing a webinar for Family Farms, a new partner and excited. Wednesday, I'll be doing a webinar with Tradier, okay, one of our brokerage partners and, of course, we love Trader because of the $10 a month. Okay, we love Trader because we have their API so that we can automate. Because by 2021, okay, we're going to be almost 99% automated from our hedging program to our equity portfolios to our futures program to everything. So I'm excited about that. Okay, and looking forward to getting forward there. And again, $10 a month is, again, why would you not want to put the money in your pocket instead of some stupid ass broker? But that's up to you. In the meantime, for futures and commodities, CTG Group. Man, they do such a great job for us. All of our letter of direction trading. They understand exactly what we're doing as well. And they work with a lot of my farmers. Why? Because I can send them an email and send the farmer the email and say, here's what we want to do. Farmer calls and connects and confirms. Boom, they get the order done. No questions asked. Easy. They don't have to be explained because obviously we use some more complex strategies to help every hedge. So CTG, Tradier, want information, either one of them, email me at bubba@bubbatrading.com. I'll send you their info. And our commodity report, unbelievable. Andy Heck does such a phenomenal job. And I got to tell you something. I mean, it's the best report I've ever read with insight and also gives you the opportunity to use some ETFs for those of you who don't want to trade commodities or don't want to be in that time frame and put some of these ETFs in your 401ks or IRAs. So again, check it out. Go to bubbatrading.com and Technamental is the name of the report. Check it out. In the meantime, don't forget about our high school program at Patreon, patreon.com/BubbaTrading. That's patreon.com/BubbaTrading. Let's get back to Bubba's Bottom Line and my commentary. Welcome back. It is Bubba's Bottom Line. This is Todd Bubba Horwitz. And of course, it is Sunday, July the 19th. And well, I don't know. I'm about COVIDed out. Okay. And I got to ask you a question. I live in the crap state of Illinois, which I've told you, you know. Okay. And they're praising Pritzker, okay, and how great they're doing. And down in Georgia, they're criticizing, okay. And of course, Illinois has been basically shut down for almost 4 months now, okay. Now, Illinois has equal to or more than cases than Georgia that's been open, okay. Same state population, okay. But one was open, one was closed. Okay, and yet the one that's closed had just as many cases, if not more, than the one that's open. Don't you think that the disease, I don't know the seriousness of it. I know the mortality rate, the death rate has fallen. Okay, I'm not taking anything away from how powerful or how bad this disease is. But don't you think that it should be a matter of choice of what people want to do, whether they want to go out or they don't want to go out? Don't you think that as Americans, we should have the freedom to, we want to go out, we go out. Look, I'm telling you, for example, my mother, 92 years old, I would not want her out running around in restaurants and doing things. I mean, to go out for dinner somewhere in a quiet place, yeah, I have no problem with that. But I don't want her in an area of places where there would be damage. But I think it should be her choice. I mean, she lives in a building now, okay, that's been locked down. That just in the last couple of weeks, they've allowed us to start visiting, okay? So again, But I think that Americans should have the freedom, if they want to go out and take a chance of exposing yourself, you can. If you don't want to go out, you don't have to. But I don't think that we should be mandated by the government telling me what I can and can't do. The mask part, I got no problem. You want to make everybody wear a mask? I could live with that. I got no issue with the mask. I think that people that fight the mask are stupid just because, again, it's ridiculous. Just put it on, do your thing, and forget about it instead of raising a battle over nothing. Okay? But overall, I do believe that you should have the right to go out. You should have the right to go where you want and do your thing. Okay? And again, I'm not saying that I'm right, but I do believe that obviously each person, each group, every age group, every health and welfare being group has a decision to make. We got to go back to school. Okay? You're destroying, you know, maybe 4, 5, 6, 7, 8-year-olds you're destroying because of this. You know what they're going to miss in this year of growth again? It's ridiculous. Okay? You got to get them in school. Either they're sick or not. Okay? You've got a high-risk child? No, you can't, but you have a high-risk child. Okay? High-risk teachers, you take your disability. Okay? But again, there's enough out there that we can get, because it's not even about the teaching, it's about the social skills, which since texting came out and these stupid iPhones came out, it's another story for another week, but since all this stuff came out, our socializing of American business and everything has taken about 9 billion steps backwards, okay? It's brutal that it's hard to actually get somebody on the phone to talk to them. But in the meantime, that's what I got to say today, baby. Everybody have a great weekend. Be healthy, be happy, enjoy, and keep on fighting. And again, we'll see you all tomorrow with Bubba's Daily Update, and be healthy. And again, you'll play the markets. Just know you're getting out when you decide to get in. We'll see you tomorrow. Have a great day. This is Bubba's Bottom Line.